Putney Debates, October 28th, 1647. I am Colonel Thomas Rainborough, a leveller.
A sexton, private soldier and elected representative, or agitator, from Fairfax's regiment of horse.
Colonel Nathaniel Rich.
John Wilde, civilian writer of leveller pamphlets, who has assisted the agitators in drawing up their proposal.
Oliver Cromwell.
Commissary General Henry Hyde.
If anyone has anything to say concerning the public business, he has liberty to speak.
And there's an amazing story about Amos Cromwell, I think, and one of these other chaps, I can't remember, end up getting on a boat to go. And something goes wrong with the boat, and they go, oh, get off. And then for some reason they decide not to do that, and you just think, that's nuts. I think that if whatever was wrong with that boat, it'd been fixed.
All inhabitants that have not lost their birthright should have an equal vote in elections. For really, I think that the poorest in England have a life to live as the greatest.
Honestly, what I think is really interesting is, supposing these states in hindsight, isn't it? But it seems to me that the personalities of these people, frankly, are so much bigger than the most of the personalities that are in the public eye at the minute, and that these issues are being tapped here with a real commitment and with a belief in this real committed belief in the high stakes of what they're fighting for, which I think is interesting by contrast, actually, to see the kind of, as you say, stunted in a slightly different way to the way that the contemporary debate is, which is sort of stunted with people sort of being judged. And a little tiny window in this, without being too whispered about it, in the last election, where you felt like people were engaging in a front foot, interested, new way, which seems to have slightly kind of withered away again. But there was a little, just when we were sort of putting the last nuts and bolts of this production, you know, the production together, when that was going on, that really felt like a very exciting conversation to be having. So I think that absolutely there is, it does have something to say, both in terms of similarity and contrast.
The question is whether any person can justly be bound by law who does not give his consent.
Yes, and I will make it clear. If a foreigner would have liberty to dwell here, he may very well be content to submit to the law of the land. If any man will receive protection from this people, he ought to be subject to those laws. If this man can think himself unsatisfied to be content to submit to this law, he may go to another kingdom.
On this point, if we stay but 3 days till you satisfy one another, the king will come and decide who will be hanged first.
It was interesting doing the debate in here, that's what came out for me, that for the those guys, you're their people, and for Iton, there's nobody out there that will be on his side. So it became really important for me to go, you need to listen to what I'm saying, you need to answer this thing. What do you mean you have a right to something? Because even now, what does that actually mean? Like, is it okay for anyone to take something, to walk into someone's house and just take it because we have human rights? When we live in an age of entitlement and apathy and indifference, and this is sort of the empty of what Iton's asking. And so it's quite hard to not make it sound privileged that he's on the side of the rich. It's actually not, it's just on the side of what is right and what is good.
It was said that if those in low condition were given their birthright, it would be destruction of